Hey guys, what's up? Doing something a little bit different on the channel today. I've been investigating some new hot weather workout, active, working on the car type gear. I had been using synthetic stuff for a while, and it works great because it dries quickly. It's easy to take care of. However, I just can't stand the stink anymore. For some reason, these fabrics just hold the smell even after you wash it, and I've used baking soda, I've used salt, I've used specialty detergents, and nothing really seems to affect it that much. I think it's just the way that the material is designed. It traps bacteria, it's hard to get the bacteria out, and it just never really truly gets clean. So maybe about a month ago, I'd purchased a bamboo shirt, which is what you see on the left there, and it's been pretty good. However, somebody turn me on to the fact that Merino wool is actually a very good summer material as well. I'm used to using that for base layers and socks for skiing, but so I figured I'd give it a shot. So I tried to look up some reviews online, and I get a lot of mixed things about, what's better, Merino or bamboo, what dries faster, the pros and cons of each. Some say bamboo dries faster, some say Merino dries faster. So today we're going to do a little experiment and see what happens. We're going to throw all of these in the washing machine, put it through a cycle, and then we're going to hang dry it here and do a little lapse time photography on it and see which one dries faster, and then see if we can come to some conclusions about which material is the best. So let's get to it. Okay, in an attempt to make this somewhat scientific, I'm going to start out by weighing all of these shirts. They're all mediums, but the fabric weight is a little bit different on all of them. I can tell that some of them have a little bit more heft than the other. I don't know the exact specs on all these fabrics. I know the Merino, I think, is an ultralight fabric at around 150 grams. The other two, the synthetic here and the bamboo here, I'm not sure what those are. So just to kind of get a baseline, I'm going to go ahead and just weigh them to see if the weight comes into play with drying time. So we're going to go with synthetic first. That's at 143. I'm going to go with the Merino next, 131. The bamboo one's going to be last. Oops. Let's get it all in there. At 156. So 157, somewhere around there. So it looks like definitely the bamboo cotton blend is the heavyweight out of the three. All right, while these things were in the washer, I was trying to figure out a good way of measuring how fast these garments are drying. And what I decided on is that I have a measurement from when the garments were dry before they went in the washer, and that the best thing to do would be to weigh them at intervals. I'm going to go every like maybe 10 or 20 minutes, and we'll know when they're dry when they weigh the same amount as they did when we started. And then we can take a look at how much weight they gained, how fast they're losing water, and ultimately which one dries the quickest. So these I'm going to do the initial weighing after coming out of the washer. I've got my scale, it's all zeroed out. This is the synthetic shirt. Get it all in the bowl there. I'm at 245 grams. Write that down. Next, we're going to go to the Merino shirt at 229 grams wet. So it's 229 grams wet. And the last is I can tell that this one's going to be the heaviest, the bamboo one. It doesn't feel great right now. It's very wet and very damp, like a towel. 360 grams. So absorbing quite a bit more water than the rest of them. All right, so I'm gonna hang these guys up and come back in 10 minutes and see where we're at. All right, it's been about 10 minutes since these left the washer. I just wanted to show you how I am hanging them up to dry. It's about 79 degrees in here. I do have the air conditioning on. There's no fans or any of the vents blowing directly at it. So that's it. It's time to go for a weigh-in. Okay, we got the setup here. I have to apologize. I lost some of the sun lighting in here, so things are going to be a little bit darker. Go with the synthetic first. We were 10 minutes ago, we were at 245. We're at 234 now. Go with the Merino, which we were at 229 before. 218 now. And then going with the Bamboo, which is still really heavy and wet. It just feels like a cotton t-shirt. It doesn't feel that great. But it could be because it weighs more, so we'll see. We were at 360 out of the washer, and we are at 345 right now.
Now for everybody's favorite moment, and the really what makes a great YouTube video, is Excel spreadsheets. So this is the compilation of all of the data that I took measuring the garments almost every 10 minutes while they were drying. So this first box up here is the garment weight in grams, and this column B is the starting or the dry weight. And then we have time here is 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 minutes, and then the weight of the actual garment at each point in time. So 0 is the time that when we measure it out of the washer, and we went all the way up to 130 minutes at 10-minute intervals, and then I had to go out, and I came back about 3 hours later, and I took another measurement. So, and then below that, we have the amount of water loss or gain each fabric took, and that's just the measure. That's just the difference between, you know, so S starting through 0 is the amount of water it gained. So we did 245 minus 146, that gives you 99, et cetera, straight across. So positive numbers is gain, negative number is how much it's losing. So what's interesting here is that the bamboo shirt was actually at dry, it was heavier than some of the other fabrics as I thought. I don't have the exact specs on it, but right here we're looking at, it's about 18% heavier than the Merino, and it's about 5% heavier than synthetic. But what's interesting is that out of the washer, it held almost 108% more water than the other two fabrics. So it's only 5 or 18% heavier of a fabric, but it had absorbed 100% more water. So coming out of the washer, you see the synthetic gained 99 grams, the Merino gained 99 grams, the Bamboo gained almost twice that at 206 grams. So right there, it's holding on to a lot more water. But then as you look at some of these numbers here, you can see that, you know, they're all kind of going down as the garment dries. And right around here, around O and P, this is when the Merino is actually starting to dry out a little bit, or I'd consider dry, because I got two consecutive measurements that are the same. So it's not losing a whole lot more water. And then you can see the difference from 130 minutes to 310 minutes is only 2 grams. Whereas, you know, the Bamboo is still drying because it went from 206 down to 166 grams in those 3 hours that I was away. But the interesting thing here is that if you look at the gain and loss of water, is that the Bamboo actually seems to be losing water faster, at a faster rate than the Merino or the synthetic garment. So it's actually drying faster, however, it absorbed more water. And just to kind of put that graphically, I made this little chart here. The gray line is the Bamboo shirt, The blue line is the synthetic shirt, and the merino line is this orange. So you can see that the merino and the synthetic are drying at about the same rate. They're slopes in this equation right here. I know this is the technical part of the analysis. Their slopes are negative 0.76 and negative 0.73. So that means that they're drying at approximately the same rate with a slight edge going to the synthetic fabric. However, you can see that this gray line, even though it starts higher, its slope is more negative than these two, which means it is losing water faster. However, you look over here, and this is the time to dry versus the weight. So the synthetic is 0.89 minutes per gram of fabric. The merino is 0.92 minutes per gram of fabric, and the bamboo is at a whopping 2 minutes per gram of fabric. So you might say, well, wait a minute, these two things are kind of, contradictory. One, over here, you're saying that it's drying faster than the other two. It's losing water quicker. However, over here, you're saying that it takes 2 minutes per gram of fabric. And so what I'm attributing that to is the fact that while the bamboo does lose water faster, it also absorbed more water in the beginning. As we can see here, it took on, like I said, almost twice as much water as the other two fabrics. So what does this all kind of boil down to? My takeaway from this is that it kind of depends on how you're going to use the shirt. If you're using all of these shirts as a workout shirt, where you're not getting it super drenched and you're not out going to be out in the rain or someplace like that, then I think bamboo is a good option because it dries as quick, if not quicker, than a merino or a synthetic shirt. However, if you're going camping or you're going someplace where you need to either wash the clothes and you want to dry it quickly and you don't have access to a dryer, or you're going someplace where you're going to get rained on and just thoroughly soaked through, or if you're going canoeing or kayaking or something, and you fall in and you need your clothes to dry fast, bamboo is definitely not a great choice because it holds on to more water when it does get wet than the merino or the synthetic. And I mean, there's a couple of other things to consider too, is that merino you can apparently wear for like a week straight without it's developing any smell. Synthetic, while we know it's a good fabric and it doesn't absorb a lot of water and it sheds the water pretty quickly, like I said before, I just can't take the stink of it. Bamboo is somewhere in the middle where you can't wear it as long as a merino. You can probably get a couple of days out of it, and then it'll start to smell from what I've read. However, then you have to factor price into all of this as well. So the synthetic is relatively inexpensive. The merino is very expensive, about twice the cost of a bamboo shirt. And the bamboo, as I said before, is somewhere in the middle. So I hope this kind of helps you. I don't have a definitive answer. The answer is, unfortunately, it depends on what you want to use the garment for. But these are my takeaways for it. And I hope it helps you in making a decision on what fabric is best for you. Well, that does it for this video. If you like what you saw, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment. If you have any questions or if you have any suggestions about other tests that you want to see done on these fabrics, just also leave those in the comment. And if you know anybody, friends, family, anybody who is struggling with, what kind of fabric that is suitable for them, don't forget to share this video with them as well. So thanks for watching and have a great day.